happy to welcome you tonight. We would like to ask you, once the concert begins, if you have to go out, not to come back in, because we're videoing the concert and it causes a lot of distraction. The next concert that we have scheduled here is the 22nd of January, the Joe English Band. I didn't want to move that for you. And for those of you that don't know anything about the Joe English Band, Joe English used to be with Paul McCartney and Wings before he went on to Better Things, which was Jesus. And he really puts together a great set of music. And this is the kind of concert that you want to tell your friends about, definitely, and bring them to. February 5th, we have Sweet Comfort, another real hot jazz rock and roll band. So those two concerts are 6:30 and 8:30, so we can get everybody in. Tonight, we're just so glad to have the Resurrection Band. They're tremendous. I listened to the first concert, and I just thought, you know, this is one of the best bands you'll ever hear. Would you welcome tonight the Resurrection Band?
Yeah! Chuck Spoon.
Thank you, good evening.
You know, it's real easy to fall in and out of love. I must have done it, you know, just scores of time. You know, growing up in high school and just trying to find someone that understood me, that would accept me, that would forgive me. You know, maybe I was even looking for someone who would change me. You know, I mean, make things all right. I mean, you know, make things right at school, my parents, at job, wherever I was. But no matter who I found, in a few months, it just kind of blew up. It was kind of like a vapor, and there was. It was all gone, and I was the same me. Somehow, they didn't look so good anymore. And then about 11 years ago, I heard about a different kind of love, and it was the kind of love that didn't just... It didn't depend on what I could do. It depended on a love that something that other person did for me. And it talked about it in an old-fashioned book, and it said that no greater love is a man than he lay down his life for a friend. And that's what Jesus Christ did for me. He laid down his life. And I had never loved anyone like that before. I mean, I was never willing to die for anyone. And I had never known anyone that loved me that much that would die for me. And that's the kind of love that I needed. I mean, it was the bottom line. And that kind of love came in and it changed me. And he accepted me and he forgave me. And that's the kind of love we're talking about tonight. And that love's amazing.
Time. My affiliation isn't with your name.
shame. Lord, you are alienated from this world. Talk about the money neglected. You alienated from this world that I'm beginning to understand. Alienated from this world. Talk about the money neglected. Alienated from this world that I'm beginning to understand. How are you doing tonight? I guess that means you're all right. We're glad to be with you again in Sacramento. Thank you.
Someone We love you so much. That's the bottom line of this whole thing. It's not to sell records. It's not to tour. It's not to make albums or to do concerts. Jesus Christ came into our lives and he changed us, and we're not ashamed of that. And too many people today are ashamed of what they believe in. But one thing that really bothers me, and that is there was a time in my life before I became a Christian, where right after I'd become a Christian, I looked back to that time, and I thought, you know, here I am as a believer, and I say he's my King and my Lord, but really, I've given more time and effort and money and thought to my sins before I asked Jesus into my life than I am now as a Christian to my Lord, to the one I call my King and my first love. I had to change, you know. I had to ask forgiveness. I know many of you are in the same place tonight. Listen, this next song is called Lonely Hearts. I had 5 relationships, pretty serious ones, before I became a Christian and eventually met my wife, Wendy, who's going to be out to sing some more in just a little bit. And before I became a believer, you know, it's drugs and sex and rock and roll, you know, like most people. But when you make a person your God, when you make another human being your Savior, they're not perfect, they're not God. And they let you down, and you let them down, and you let yourself down, because you're not genuine and real. You're worshiping things and people, not God. Or you're worshiping yourself. Finally, man, every one of those relationships, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, I walked out on them before I figured they're probably gonna walk out on me sooner or later anyway, so I may as well split first. Everybody in my family has been divorced at least once, except me and my wife, because we met as Christians. Because we love Jesus and his love is in our marriage, and that's what sticks it together and holds it together. And I'm ashamed, and I feel very sorry both for those who call themselves Christians who've given themselves quick grounds to say goodbye to their mates. That's a whole nother story. Sure, there are times when that kind of a thing has to break up, but love is so cheap in this world. God's love is not cheap. It costs Jesus everything. That's what it'll cost you. That's what it'll cost me. This song talks about a person who sticks an ad in a column, in the Lonely Hearts column, in the want ads, you know, in the personals. Because she's finally gotten to the point where she wants to find somebody so bad. But she advertises because she feels that alone. There's a lot of people like that in this world. A lot of people here tonight, I'm sure, in that same place. There's only one who's right, and the rest of us are wrong. Until we hold his love inside, until we sing his song, that's what it's all about. That's what we're all about.
Down, wouldn't call you a sinner, but I've been out of town. Now it might sound crazy, still I'm going to say it. Jesus made me care for you, the debt we owed, he paid it. Lonely hearts, hidden pills, cigarettes and late night pills. Place to add, a baby soon, someone shares an empty room.
For a long time, a lot of people have requested this one. And we just hadn't done it for a long time, so we didn't know how to play it anymore. I'm serious. But we've been practicing, so we'll do this for those oldie goldie Res Band fans out there. This one's for you.
Yeah.
Be right back.